can't block him because he can just keep going around in a circle here. So I want him to sit. So I give the affection. Keep his focus here by licking the neck. See? I don't need to hold the collar. I just lick his neck. He moves his head. I bring my hand to the other side. Touch, release. Touch, release. You're blocking the head. And this is where I'm asking him. There we go. See the focus? That's perfect. So that conversation right there was just ignore everything that's going on. Don't try to move away. Just stay there. It's like a 3-year-old trying to get their coat on. You know, winter coat and snow pants and everything. So it's just a little touch, release, touch, release. You stop touching with the fingers. Touch, release. And then look at the neck. So I want the hip up. That's where I bring my hand under. When they're pushing their head down, you lift up, release. It's just a touch. Everything is just a touch, release. Now I get both hands going with the affection. Let him smell the leash. He associates the leash with the affection of the mother, the licking of the neck. Some dogs want to take a little bit longer to smell things than others, especially dogs that have trust issues. You have to be mindful of the dog smelling and wait until the dog is finished smelling before you move forward with the dog. So if you're trying to put on a leash or a collar over and they're smelling and you go to put it on and they lift their head up like that, they're not done smelling and they'll back up and move away. And that's what we're saying, I'm not done smelling. The dog knows the world through their nose first. Alright, so now I got the leash. I can use leash to correct and block movement. So he did really good. So I want him to associate me. See, holding out my hand. He comes. See, block the focus. Bring it back to me. He looks right at me. So now I want to get to where I put my head over his head. The mother puts her head over her puppy's head, but she doesn't do it out of dominance. So here, see, if he backs up, I use the leash to block that motion, block the focus. The reward for focus is my affection. So a mom doesn't put her head over out of dominance. She does it as a way of saying, I'm an umbrella of protection over you. So you could be at a gun range doing this. Explosions going off all around you. Every time they focus, correct, correct, correct. So he brings his head down. I lift up a little. That made him move back. I block the move back. This is asking him to come forward. So I close my eyes and soften my eyes when I'm looking at it. Right there. So what I'm waiting for is as I'm licking both sides of the neck, they lay their head down. And as soon as they lay their head down, you bring your head over their head. When you have a dominant dog, like him, or sorry, her, young dominant dog, puppy, you watch them when they play, they always want to be over. So, if they don't see you as the mother, we're building that relationship right here through the affection. They don't see you as the mother, then when you put your head over their head, they see it as dominance, play, challenge. And they're going to lift their head up, they're going to move back, they're going to do whatever. Everything from that to some dogs will bite you. Come. Come. Yes. So again, holding out the hand, she's learning. When I hold out the hand, you come to me, I lick your neck. So I'm just waiting here. So you see again, as soon as I go over a little bit, she looks. I'm just going to concentrate on her here for a second. I got to make sure that this leash is totally loose. I don't want any tension anywhere. Right there. And then once we have that connection for the dominant dog, you can pet him on the head and touch the back, touch the bum. Because now they don't see you coming over them as dominance. They see you coming over them as an umbrella of protection. You're the mother. So now put her back in the crate. I want her to lay down. So she goes forward. I move into her space. It's hard to do with the crate. So she just steps back. As we sit. See how she's not laid down fully, she's holding herself up just a little bit. She knows I see that. That's why I'm still projecting lay down even as I'm coming back up. Start over. She associates the door with getting out, excitement. I want her to associate the door with just laying down relax. So now this look here, that was avoidance. Just kind of, it's kind of down and turned to the side a little bit, and that's avoidance. And that's where they're saying, you're not my mom, I don't have to look at you. And that's where you just keep staring at her without blinking. Good girl. So now, lay down the back. No, and you're just doing so good. You're just watching everything. So this is Zola. Zola is 8 months old. And, this one is 9 months old. Fire. 9 months old. Nine old. Just giving affection on both sides, bringing your head over and kissing the top of their head, and you feel them. They just melt right into your hand. A dog that was just vicious towards you, bites you. As soon as you start doing this, they just melt right into your hands, don't they? Hi, baby. You're such a good girl. So Zola is helping because she's projecting the energy and behavior that I'm looking for. So now, you see, so this is what I mean by, if you want peace, be the peace, create the peace, just learn how to ask your dog how to just sit or lay down, relax. How long she took to smell there? Trying to pet them before they're ready for you to pet them. Again, that's, they see that as disrespect. So we'll ring the doorbell again. Do that. She growls, I make the tiss noise and say, no, don't growl. And then you get to the point where they're sound asleep, you ring the doorbell and they don't even flinch. And it's because she now knows that I got it taken care of. I'm worrying about who's coming into our den. I'm protecting her. She doesn't need to be territorial or thinking that she needs to protect me.